TriRazorEducation.com, and I want to take you through step number 4, which is clean partings and sectioning. So we're going to start off. I like to use some sort of cutting lotion. They call it a cutting lotion, but really it's just a nice soft hold gel. And what I'm going to do is run that through the hair, mostly through the ends at first, and then we'll work it through the base. The reason I'm doing this is because it's going to give the hair some slip, but it's also going to help keep the sections cleaner and keep the hair stuck together as we comb. So I'll get that product in, work it through with a wide tooth comb. You want to make sure before you start cutting hair, you get every tangle out of the hair and get it nice and clean and organized. I'm going to show you sectioning that I like to use. So we're going to start off by taking a clean parting. How do we do a clean parting? The way that we're going to do that is I'm going to comb the hair. We get it flowing in the direction we want to take the part. So if I want to take a part around the head, I'm going to comb the hair around the head and work it through there. So I'm just going to start with the tip of the comb and draw a line. I like to put my pointer finger where I want it to go, stabilize it there, then drag the comb through, and then as soon as I get it where I want it, then I can let it go, hold the hair with my finger, and comb the rest of it out. So we're going to start the corner of the eye there. We're going to work our way around, still using the point of the comb. I'll show you the sectioning as soon as I get this through here. We're just going to take a rectangle off the top of the head. Basically, all I'm doing is following the curvature of the head because that's going to determine how I cut the hair and where I hold it and elevate it. So I'm going to lift the hair up. Now I'm going to twist the hair. That's a really important thing. We're going to put this, get it all out of the way. She has a little bit of layering in there, but so we want to keep it so it's nice and clean and neat. We take our first clip. We'll comb it there. Now what I want to do, after I get that, I just want to check and see the balance in there. Looks pretty good, looks pretty even. So now what I'm going to do is I want to take a section from where we're at on the parietal here and at the first curve of the head. So I'm going to lay my comb down where it rocks. That's where I'm going to make my next parting. So again, just using that technique, using just the point of the comb to take my part. So we'll twist it up. I'm going to keep twisting the hair until it starts to twist around itself. It's so much better to section your hair this way as opposed to just kind of wrapping it up and clipping it real quick because it's going to help peel the hair away from the other section so that you don't get them tangled together. Grab a clip. We're going to do the same thing on the opposite side. So I'm going to find where the hair, where the head starts to peel away. You could really see that by just putting your comb down in the hair and where it starts to move out. That's where I want to make my section. So this is going to be different on each person because everyone has a little bit different shape, but it'll all kind of basically end up the same. Now I'll twist that again. Twist it until it twists around itself. That'll keep it nice and tight, clean, and out of the way. A lot of times I see in classes, a lot of people are using butterfly clips, big chunky clips. So when you have a small section you're trying to keep clean, those clips just are gonna get in the way. So try to find a nice sleek clip that you can use. Now we're gonna section right down the center back. I'm going to use that wide front tooth of the comb right down the center, part that over, and then we all know that there's a bone here called the occipital bone. That's where I want to draw my line across, and that will separate the hair. So I'll twist that section up, clip it away, and I'll do the same with the opposite side. Right here. And then the same thing on this side, I'll follow that line over. Twist it nice and clean and out of the way. Now this is the basic sectioning that I use for most haircuts that I do. just because what you'll see in step number five that we're going to go over is that this just basically flat out shows you exactly where the rounds of the head are. So as you're elevating the hair and you're going through it, you're going to notice where you want to change your elevation and what you're going to be doing in the haircut. So we're going to get more into that in the next step. So I hope this makes sense to you guys. I hope it makes you a little bit more organized. Work on key things in this is how to section the hair, how to part the hair, and how to wrap it up and clip it. Once you guys get that down, then we'll move to step number five next on understanding the head shape and how this sectioning works with the head shape. So make sure you subscribe, follow us on Facebook, Free Salon Education, and also check us out on freesaloneducation.com. Thanks.